And in a sick, twisted way, I think this is what he wants. Now, siren-tastic, but I talked to an NBA executive this weekend. And this person, no, I mean, Mike, it's just facts are facts, and it's not anyone local, so you're never going to know who it was. The point is, his opinion, and some of the people he talks to, it was his opinion KD could have played early. That in essence, it was going to take the back against the wall scenario for him to come back. His opinion, that's not some news story. It's an opinion of someone who is in the NBA. I just wonder, would KD be back if they were up? I don't think so. Is it a hot take that if the Warriors were up 3-1 in this series, KD doesn't play tonight? It's almost like this was the only way he was going to come out. No breaking news. Just opinions. But this is what he wanted. And remember, if he plays the whole way and they win, he gets no credit. If he plays the whole way and they lose, he gets crushed. Without him playing and they lose, he still gets credit. Because it would have opened the world's eyes to what they already should have known. KD's best player in the world. But KD will never, barring a 3-1 comeback here, KD will never get credit for anything he's done in Golden State. Unless he comes back and guides them to this NBA title. Now, I'm not saying that's right. I'm just telling you it's real. So I think the drama in tonight's game, you've got it both ways. You have Kevin Durant coming back with no idea what he's going to look like. None. Going against a Toronto team who, I'm not surprised they're going to win the series. I'm surprised they have a chance to do it in five. I mean, David and I, we were going to pour a ton of money into David's church coffers. We had plus 1,200. Raptors had six. And I thought that was impressive. I'm surprised they're going to do it in five, but you have, it's going to be a madhouse. And I always want to call it Air Canada Center, Scotiabank, whatever. But it's going to be an absolute madhouse tonight. You have a chance for a team to win its first NBA championship. You have the drama of Kawhi possibly capping off, I'm going to say, the greatest postseason in NBA history. You can dog that opinion if you want.
He's an idiot.
Now, KD, that's not fair. Kawhi is offering you 31-9 a night. Hit one of the only, if not the only, game-winning shot in a Game 7. He was basically on one leg for at least half the playoffs. He's given you 31-9 while being the best defender in basketball. And he has transformed a team from being a pretender to a contender. I think Kawhi's capping off the greatest postseason in history if he can finish this. And oh, by the way, no one remembers this. This would be his second NBA Finals MVP. He's 27. And oh, by the way, and David deserves credit on this. Weeks ago, I said I would need him to get back in it. Well, he's doing it. I mean, tonight, to me, you don't even have to like basketball. You just tune in. The Jurassic Park stuff, the arena is going to be insane. You've got the Drake factor.
Saying that KD was practicing and that he might play.
So that right there was telling you that from the inside, mm-hmm. they were pressuring KD to play because they believed that he was just holding out to prove that point, that you need me. And without me, you can't do anything.
Oh, and again, none of us have medicals. Right. So to make statements as fact would be irresponsible. Mm-hmm. I'm not doing that. I'm giving you an opinion from someone who's in the NBA. But that was absolutely expressed, is that, look, none of us have the medicals, but if what they're saying the actual injury is, he should be back.
I agree.
So that's the opinion.
And when you go back to what Draymond and KD went through earlier in the year and the argument that they had, and the quote from Draymond is, we don't need him. We don't need KD. But KD never had an opportunity in a moment to prove.
Well, the moment's now.
This is the moment, and I think he took it.
But
in
my
opinion, I think he took it.
I think you'll know within 4 or 5 minutes what he's got.
Oh, yes.
And again, him playing well for one night, a la Boogie Cousins, that's different than playing. They're going to need him at 90%
yes.
of peak KD
yes.
to pull this out, because straight up, Toronto's the better team. They've been the better team in every game this series. They had, you know how many quarters the Warriors have been better? Like literally one.
Yeah, maybe.
The third quarter of game two.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. Oh, well, they had a 4-point lead the other night, you jerk. I didn't think Golden State played that great.
They did.
Toronto just played worse. Like, Toronto is better than the Warriors without KD.
But here's the thing, and for those that are listening that may not know the full story of KD's injury, it's been a month now. So, will conditioning be an issue? Because you're right, they need 90% of him, which means they need full, like, they need it.
I can't wait.
They don't need no, you know, let's wait for over right. the second quarter. No, they need it.
No, I can't wait for it tonight. Now, we'll get back to business here with some of the golf stuff. And if you want to chime in about the NBA Finals, you know I'm here for it. I'm here for all of that. I think it's must-see TV. 248-539-9797. Writing. Sully, you also have a couple courses you believe were snubbed.
Absolutely, I do.
We'll get those as well. Next, 97.1.
And his friends like Dodge does the deals the other dealers won't. We're overstocked and must sell a new surplus inventory regardless of loss. The best way for us to sell our surplus Dodge RX is two at a time. That's a try two for 2022. Follow the Kelly and his friend like Dodge and Warren. Yes, a true silent drive and two Chrome 19 Ram 1500 crew cab for 4-wheel drives for just $222 per month.
Thank you.
game five from Toronto. Golden State, of course, down 3-1. And despite being 1-1 away from winning Toronto's first NBA title, Kawhi Leonard says nothing has settled yet.
We know that it doesn't mean anything until someone has 4 wins. You never know what could happen. And you gotta take advantage of it. And, you know, don't get overly hyped and excited. Still a great basketball team on the other side.
Kevin Durant, who has not played since May 8th, says he does plan to play tonight after practicing this morning. And Coach Steve Kerr says getting him back will help with the team's fatigue and injury issue.
That's why I'm pleased that there's been 2 days, or there will be 2 days before the next game and the next couple after that, if we can keep extending the series. And as we get healthier and have some time to heal and rest, I like our chances. So we'll see what happens.
Tip-off for tonight's game is set for just after 9. Stanley Cup Finals the next couple of nights off and resume on Wednesday. That series shifting back to Boston for a decisive Game 7 between the Bruins and Blues. Tigers also with the night off tonight. They'll come back to work tomorrow as the opening 3-game series with the Royals in Kansas City. The Royals. We'll take an update next. Come Ryan Woolley for more. Go to 971theticket.com.
In order for me to tell you about myself, I just can't give you a whole spirit. I don't even know where you're sitting at.
Talking the free press top 10 public golf courses. Zully's played 7 of them. He's totally trashed a couple of these places, so I'm sorry if you're affiliated with them. But we're getting people involved, and look, the top 3, no one has guessed them. And Zully's getting upset because he thinks they're no-brainers. So I'm going to get some people involved. 3:30, we've got the CBS report, the NFL divisions by quality of quarterback. Something very interesting. Always got to get a little football. Let's go to Justin on a sale 97.1. Justin, how you doing?
Guys, how's it going today?
Excellent. Talk to me here. What is a course that should be on this list?
Well, I know the number one's got to be the Orchards out in Washington Township.
Ooh. Well, Justin, you're correct. And before we get your take, let me tell you what the freak had to say. As if we're supposed to know who Robert Trent Jones Jr. is.
You don't know who that is?
I have no clue who that is.